Hello everybody, this is Minecralix here, and welcome to another World Border or Bust video of Rising World. Now this is my second installation, my second episode in the series, and this is the world that I'm playing in, Edge of the World Survival, just a regular vanilla world with all of the regular presets. Now let's just dive in and, try to get to the world border. In the last episode, we just gathered some resources, just set up a small base to basically gather all the resources that we are going to need on our extremely long journey. Almost completely never ending, because guys, I mean, this journey, it's like, it practically is never gonna end, because I don't even know how long it's gonna take to walk to the edge of the world. It's practically impossible, because, like we know, the world in Rising World, just like in Minecraft, is infinite. However, the world in Minecraft, it is infinite, but when you get to the edge of the world, it just kind of starts glitching out, and you can really see that you're getting closer to the end of the world. So let's dive in here, and let's run. Okay, now it looks like I've been stuck for a small while there. Now, as you can see, I got my whole base going now. This is my little base here. I have my chest with some of the resources that we're going to need. I have quite a bit of food. I have quite a bit of saplings. I'm going to smelt a bit more of this ore, and then hopefully we're going to be able to go on our journey. Now we can see right here, I'm cooking my bacon right over here. Now when it's going to be done, it's hopefully going to turn into this nice kind of yellow tingy flavor color or something like that. But if we leave it for too long, it's going to turn black, and when it's going to turn black, what's going to happen is it's going to become burnt bacon, and in that case, it's not going to refill as much health as, it's not going to refill as much hunger as just regular cooked bacon will. And also, I have burnt bacon before, and what happens when you eat burnt bacon is, basically, you become really, really thirsty, so it's also really nice to carry around a flask of water with me at all times. Now, like I did show in the previous episode, I'm not able to fill up water, my water canteen, from this water source right here, because it's an ocean, and like all we all know, the ocean is salty water, and that's why we can't drink it. Same in Rising World, we can only drink water from just little ponds or lakes that are inside these lush green forests. And now we can already see that our bacon has turned yellow and has turned into cooked bacon. And right here we can see on the left side corner, I mean on the right side of the screen, you can see it says times one bacon cooked. So now we have 10 bacon right here. Now we're gonna be able to go inside our chest right here and cook a bit more of this bacon. Now I'm going to try to maximize the space on this stove so that I'm going to place the biggest amount of bacon on this grill right here, just so it's gonna take faster to process all the bacon into cooked bacon. Now I don't know if this actually affects the efficiency of cooking the bacon or not, but I'm going to just put it really, really tight down here, just so we're gonna be able to head out on our journey as soon as possible, because I'm getting a bit tired of collecting resources. I actually want to start going and heading out on our journey. Now, like I said before, we're going to run really, really fast, hopefully. And by that I mean I'm practically going to go like this for most of the way, just by pressing shift. So we're not just going to be walking, we're going to be running, but of course if we're collecting resources, we're just going to be walking. And also one reason why I need so much food to be ready is also because just in case, because since we're going to run a lot, it's going to deplete a lot of our hunger, and in Rising World, the more you run, the more hunger is depleted. So like I said before, we're going to, oh my god, that's huge. Now let's see if we can get all of this on here. Oh my god. Just took a screenshot of that. We're having a nice barbecue here, guys, huh? So now, one thing is that it's probably going to be difficult to collect the bacon, so I'm probably going to take the ribs off the grill, just because if you look down here, if you look down here, you can see how this kind of covers the bacon. Now let's see, if we look under here, it covers the bacon too, but hopefully this and this is going to get cooked at pretty much the same time, just because we placed it. So hopefully we're going to collect all this as soon as it's cooked. Now our copper ore is still inside the furnace right here. Now let's see, I might make some cloth, or did I already make cloth? Okay, so I have cotton right here. Oh yeah, we made 12 bandages in the last episode, I remember that. And also another problem here is that I don't know if we're going to really have enough space in our inventory to carry all this with us. Now I'm really thinking, what can we drop down here? So obviously we're not going to be able to carry everything that's in the chest, because our inventory is practically already almost all filled up. So the first order of business to drop things would be, I'm going to first drop stone, just because stone is one of the easiest resources to acquire in Rising World. You just go underground and then mine stone like we just did down there. Now let's see, it's still being cooked. Oh, now it's getting to be nighttime, so hopefully all of our ore is going to be cooked pretty soon so we can leave. Now let's see, we have 14 silver ore, 26 tungsten ore left to smelt. Now we have quite a bit of iron ingots and quite a bit of copper. Now I know that copper isn't the most useful resource, however I still want to carry it with me just to make sure, because I really don't know when the next opportunity is going to come to acquire copper. And it's nice, you can see the smoke kind of coming up there from it being smelted. Oh, we got our copper ingots right here, so let's just collect all of this. And once again, on the right hand of the screen, you can see times one copper ingot. Now let's just collect all this. And I don't know if you guys know, if you have ever played Rising World before, you probably know the controls, but unlike some other games... Okay, now let's just fill all this up back again with tungsten ore. Now, if you guys have played Rising World before, you probably know the controls, but if you have never played Rising World before, you don't know the controls. But basically, Rising World has quite interesting controls, because most of the time, the button E is basically the universal button in video games to use things. Like we know in Half-Life and Doom and practically... Oh, it's all done now. It looks like the tighter that I stack the bacon, it does not really affect its cooking. So, what was I saying? Yeah, so basically, if you have ever played something like Doom or Duke Nukem or Half-Life or Team Fortress Classic, or pretty much any game like that before, and hopefully you have, because those games are one of my favorite games. It's very, very great games. Half-Life is just amazing. Let's hope they release Half-Life 3 soon, but most likely they're not going to release Half-Life 3 anytime soon. But we Valve fans believe that Half-Life is going to get released. So yeah, hopefully Gabe comes to his senses and stops just updating Steam and everything. But of course, this game is kind of Valve supported as well, because obviously Rising World is on Steam, and it's pretty much the only place that you can get Rising World, unless of course you pirate the game, you're going to use it on Steam. Now anyway, it looks like it got cooked. Now as you can see, it does not really turn into a different color, you can just see the lines on there, the gray lines. Oh, so looks like we got some beef steak cooked. Now let's put the ribs on there. And also, an issue with the ribs is that the ribs are very difficult to stack. As you can see, they're not able to be stacked. And it's kind of obvious to see that, because they're so huge. That's why they take up a whole one spot in the inventory. So like I was saying, practically the universal button to use anything in a game is E. And that's how it goes for Half-Life, Team Fortress, Duke Nukem. You basically come up to anything and then you press E and then you use it. Say for example you're playing Half-Life and then there's some kind of recharging health pack. And then you just come up and then you press E and then it replenishes your health. However, Rising World is not like this. To use something you actually have to press F. So right now I'm pressing, every time I open this chest, I'm pressing F. Now, like in Minecraft, you can right-click on a chest and then it's going to open. However, you can't do that in Rising World. So basically, the only way to open this chest is to press F, and then you press escape to close it. And then you press F, and then escape to close it. Now, one thing that I think it is because F on most office keyboards has this little raised up thingy for it, so that's why I think the reason why it has such, the reason why, you can use F to open things. Okay, now I'm really tired of having this thing just walk around here. I think I'm going to try to kill it. Now I have bandages just in case I start bleeding, so I'll just start hitting this thing. Well, that was pretty fast. Okay, now let's see. What's in its inventory? Aw, it didn't give us anything. So, yep, I'll just hide the body and see it disappear. Now I'm thinking I probably should turn quite a bit of the stone into stone bricks, just because that way it's going to be most efficient. Obviously, I need blocks and quite a bit of blocks on my journey. Now, of course, I will be gathering wood on my way, and if I run out of blocks, I'm most likely going to just mine down, gather some more stone. So I will be actually collecting quite a bit more resources on my way to the edge of the world. Now hopefully, let's see. Now I'm just going to place all this stone down here. Now most likely we're going to leave it. Now I don't know about sand or dirt. I think sand is quite an efficient resource. It's quite a needed resource as well, just because we're on the beach. That's why I think that sand would be a nice resource to keep. Now, the only thing that I'm really waiting on now is to basically smelt all of my ores, and then that way we can just go and leave. So now let's see, is there anything that we missed here? I actually think that I'm going to abandon this mine here, just because, as you can see, I don't have any torches or anything like that, so that's what I think I'm going to do. As you can see right here, I have 38 sand, and what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to just fill up on the sand, and by that I mean just to conserve inventory space. I'm going to have practically every single inventory space be filled up to the brim with 64 material. That's one thing that is very close to Minecraft, because like we know in Minecraft, every basically inventory space can hold 64 of the same item unless it's not stackable. So basically every item can, every inventory space can hold, okay, we're probably gonna, yep, there we go, exactly 64. So every inventory space can hold 64 items. Now let me show you. Now what happens if I mine more? It's going to go into the different inventory space, and we can see now it maxed out this inventory spot, so it went to that inventory spot. So now I'm able to just drop it by pressing Q. So right here we can see these sand items here. Or another thing I can do is I can just simply replace sand right here. You can see it just goes like this, and we can just make organic structures unlike in Minecraft. Oh, now our health, no, I mean as in our, okay, wow, this takes a long time to cook through. Well, I guess just because it's so big. Now it looks like our hunger is kind of going down a bit, so let's just eat one piece of bacon. I could eat a second one, I don't know, I have quite a bit of food. I'm definitely not going to have any problems with food in Rising World, considering I'm going to be running a nomadic lifestyle. I'm just going to be collecting wild fruits, wild plants, and killing off wild animals, such as that antelope or that bull or whatever the thing that I killed there. Okay, now we have 24 tungsten. Now let's just replace that with 19 copper ore. Now let's hope all this fits in here. I did used to remember the amount of ore that can fit in, but now I kind of forgot it. Okay, 3. And one thing, I don't remember if I mentioned this or not, but if you look up in the top right hand side, you can see that there's in the really, really, really top right hand side, you can see that there's this little icon of copper ore, and then it says 2, and then as I place this, it kind of goes down to 1, and then it ends. So now I'm gonna put a bit more tungsten ore in here, and also you can basically mix and match all of the ores that you want to, so you don't have to like smelt each ore individually. And unfortunately we do still have some silver ore that I have to smelt, so we're going to have to do another batch here and then another batch there. Actually, on the other hand, you know what I think I'm going to do? I think I'm going to craft another furnace just because I'm too lazy to wait. So now let's see. The furnace is inside the crafting station. So this takes 128 stone and 4 lumber. Now let's see how much stone we have. Unfortunately, I really should have not crafted most of my stone into blocks, because now I do not have enough stone to craft a furnace, unfortunately, but I guess we're just going to have to wait. So now let's just run around. Let's go. I'm gonna fill my canteen. Actually, on the other hand, I should not fill my canteen, and the reason for that is because I really do not want to abandon my steak, my rib right here, because what's gonna happen is it's going to get cooked, and then by the time that I'm going to return, it's all going to be charred, and I really need this steak because ribs, just because it replenishes a lot of health. It replenishes a lot of hunger. So now let me just take a screenshot of that, just because I really like the texture of the ribs. If you look closely, it just looks really, really nice. Like, just look at the texture right here. The textures are definitely much better in Minecraft. I'm not saying that Rising World is necessarily better than Minecraft. Well, in some cases, Rising World is better than Minecraft, but in other cases, Minecraft is better than Rising World. So now this is going to take quite a bit of time to smelt. I'm not really sure what I'm going to do right now. I'm just waiting for both of this and both of this to get cooked and smelted. Now, unfortunately, we will have to... Oh, I didn't know that. If you can see down there, it says you must stand in front of an object to use it. So apparently I can open it like this, but I can't open it like this. So yeah, apparently you do have to only open it from the front. Another thing is not included in Minecraft is because in Minecraft you can practically open a chest from anywhere. You can open a chest from the back, you can open a chest from the side, you can open a chest from really far out, but in Rising World you can only open the chest like in this little area right here. Another thing that is similar to Minecraft is the crosshair, because as you can see, there's this little cross right there, which looks almost exactly the same to Minecraft's, except it's a bit smaller than that of Minecraft. Now let's see, did we weave all of our cloth? Okay, so we have cotton, camping. Oh, looks like I can make a bit more cloth there. So now let me see. Should I make more cloth? Well, I think that I'm just going to leave that out there. Now, I think that one-man tent ideal for camping. Now, I'm not sure, is there really any item that I can really place down and then pick back up again? So, I'm going to risk it, because most items in Rising World cannot be picked up again. Actually, practically almost all items. Oh, there we go. Wow, look at that savory rib. It's pretty nice. Yep, we still have quite a bit of inventory space. Well, not quite a bit, but we do have enough for the smelted ore that we're going to get right now. So now, like I said before, most items in Rising World can be picked back up again. Actually, most items can be picked up again, because this... I'm pretty sure that this grill right here can't be picked up. What else can be picked up? Well, let me just place down a block right here, and as you can see, I placed a block here, and now I'm going to attempt to pick it back up again, and now it's gone. So practically, once I place it, I cannot pick it back up again, and this is practically with all of the other items in Rising World. Now let's see, I'm going to attempt to pick back up this grill right here, and most likely I'm not going to be able to pick it back up. I might be able to. I'm almost completely certain that I'm not able to pick up the campfire, but let's see, maybe we might be able to pick up the grill. I have never actually tried before, so let's just start hitting it with our pickaxe right here. Oh, let's just have to make sure that it hits the grill itself instead of... Yep, and as you can see, the grill just simply vanished. That's quite unfortunate, because that means every time we're going to have to cook any type of meat or any type of animal resources such as that, we're going to have to craft an anvil just to craft the the plates just to craft the grail, so most likely we are going to rely on wild fruits instead of eating the cooked meat, because cooked meat is more suitable to, and as you can see, it's slowly turning into the smelted ingots from the ore, from the respective ores. For example, the copper ore turns into the copper ingot. Now this one's going to smelt and turn into the nice smooth copper ingot. There we go, nice tungsten, and now the silver. But unfortunately, we do have to smelt more of it, so let's just place it right here, and now we can see the silver turn into its respective ingot as well. Now, like I said before, every time we stop and we get some meat, we're going to have to craft an anvil. And then, using an anvil, we're going to have to craft the silver plates. No, not the silver plates, but I mean the iron plate. And then from the iron plate, we're going to have to craft... I think it's inside, yeah, I don't really know exactly where it is. I think it's inside utilities. Oh, yeah, so... One thing that they added with this new update is actually dynamite, which is pretty interesting. They also added some flares as well. There was an update quite recently. Also, they added scaffoldings. I think these are for building large objects. Rising World is really building intensive in the sense that you can really build a lot of awesome things in Rising World. Now, let's see. I'm pretty sure I kind of actually forgot. I haven't played Rising World in quite a long time, since the last time that I posted another episode. Oh, there we go. So, since the last time that I posted the last episode, I haven't played any Rising World, so that's about a month or so, maybe 2 months, I don't know. So yeah, there we go, cooking grill. So every time we want to make a cooking grill, we're going to have to go down, mine some stone, make a furnace, mine some coal, fill up the furnace, then mine some iron, fill up the furnace with iron, smelt the iron, create an anvil, chop down trees, create a crafting station. Actually, the crafting station has to be first, just because we have to craft the furnace to smelt the iron, obviously. But after that, we're going to have to craft an anvil, and then we're going to craft some... And then we're going to have to go and mine some more iron if we don't have enough smelted in the furnace. And then we're going to have to craft some iron plates and iron rods. And then we're going to craft a cooking grill. And then we're going to craft... And then we're going to have to craft a campfire. And then we're going to have to put our cooking grill over the top of it, and that's how long it takes to just smelt the food. No, I mean not smelt the food, but I mean cook the bacon or ribs or beefsteak or whatever we collect along the way to the edge of the world. So yeah, most likely we're going to not be able to smelt things very often, actually quite rarely. Hopefully, if we do find some really, really tall mountains, and I have played Rising World for quite a long time now, I have seen very, very, very tall mountains in Rising World, and many times these tall mountains, they expose a lot of the ore, so if we are on our way to the edge of the world, edge of the map, and we're going to encounter mountains, which I'm almost 100% sure that we will encounter mountains at some point, pretty tall mountains. And many of the mountains in Rising World contain basically ore that is on top of the surface, so we're gonna find quite a bit of iron ore there that's going to be exposed to the surface. So that's pretty much the only time that we're going to actually mine ores, because obviously, with our nomadic lifestyle that we're going to always keep on moving, we're not going to have time to mine downwards and attempt to find ores underneath. We're only going to have time to just collect the resources that are immediately accessible to us, such as those on top of the ground, such as the trees, such as the animals, such as the wild fruits. Of course, we're not going to be able to farm or anything like that. As much as I like farming and architecture in Rising World, we're not going to be able to build really, really large structures or large bases. We're only going to be able to build just tiny tents and little bases like this. Most likely, we're not even going to be able to build such small bases such as even this one. Most likely, we're going to only be able to build just small ledges, small campfires, just little furnaces, and that's pretty much the only building that we're going to be able to do in this type of Let's Play. So, yeah. So, like I said, as much as I like doing architecture in Rising World, we're not going to be able to build really large bases or large buildings. Hopefully, I am going to start some more Let's Plays in which we will build a lot of things. This is just not simply the type of game mode or purpose for us that I'm going to have. Now, let's see. Actually, I think that we might gonna... Oh, do we have a scythe? Oh, really? I did not craft a scythe in the last episode? That's kind of weird. Now, I actually think that we're most likely going to have to dump practically all of these stone blocks for now. Now let's see, I think that I'm also going to have to dump some of the logs, just because, let's see, there's a cherry log, there's a palm log. Well, I think that we're going to just dump the palm log and the cherry log. I really do like the palm and cherry logs, however, we really try to, we're really going to try to conserve resource space, to inventory space. And to do that, we're going to have to consolidate all of our resources just so we would have a lot of the items and one in one spot. And to do that, I'm just going to have to throw out all of the other types of wood that we're not going to encounter. These are the types of wood that we're going to be encountering most often in this kind of environment. So I'm just going to dump all of this right here and only carry this wood with me. And we do have enough. There's 37 logs here and 15 logs here. And we are definitely going to collect... Oh. Looks like it ran out of fuel. I never had it run out of fuel before. And we were quite lucky to have it be smelted by the time that it ran out of fuel. So, yep. So now let's just organize everything. So now let's have all of my ingots right over here. Now, this is... The organization isn't very good here. I like to have good organization, especially if I'm having the type of resources that I have to carry for long periods of time. So all of our mineables are going to be right here. So now let's place all of the foods in this row right here, and in this row right over here. Oh, there's still iron here. So yeah, we're going to have to place iron right here. So all of our food's going to go down here, including our strawberries right here, including our ribs right here. So all of our logs are going to go right here. Now our just general resources are going to go up here. Our food's going to go up here. So now let's see. I think that I'm also going to craft a scythe just in case. So now let's see. Maybe I'm going to most likely also craft, let's see. I think I'm going to craft a sword blade as well, just in case, because, there's going to be some threats that are going to be facing us, while we're going to be traveling, just in case I don't die, because that's just going to be really bad, because I'm going to lose everything that I have. So now I'll just craft, let's see. Oh, there it goes. It's under weapons. I just forgot. Oh, we do need one stick to craft that. So let's just go into our inventory here. Go to resources, lumber, some sticks, and then just let's craft a sword. So this is our sword's going to be up here. So now let's see. I also want to craft a scythe and a sickle. So a scythe and a sickle. And this does take up quite a bit of inventory space, but these are very useful items that we might need in the future. And since I'm not going to have access to anvils for quite a long time, like I said before, it requires a lot of iron to make them, and of course that requires to build a base. So, let's see. Sickle, scythe. And there we go. Now we have all the tools that I need, that we are going to need. Now I'm going to dump my sticks back in here just because they're taking up inventory space. Now let's see. Now I'm most likely going to sleep just one night here, just so I'm going to be able to depart in the morning, just so I have a lot of daylight. Now even though Rising World does not really have any monsters or any mobs that spawn during the nighttime, it's very difficult to travel at night, even if you have a torch with you, so I'm going to have to look out for that. I'm going to have to travel during the daytime, and every time it's going to be nighttime, I'm just going to craft a small shelter for myself to sleep. That's going to be most efficient. So now let's see. So we don't have space for that stone. So I'm most likely... Oh yeah, there it goes. So I'm just going to place all of this right over here. Now I'm thinking... I'm not going to take any of the saplings with me just because... I'm going to be able to cut down the trees on my way. I'm not going to be able to grow any trees. So I'm just going to leave all the saplings right here just because saplings are... basically used to grow trees in Rising World, just like in Minecraft, of course. And these saplings, they take a very, very, very long time to actually grow into trees. Believe me, it takes like a week in Rising World just to grow one tree. And obviously, we're not going to stay in one place for a week, so that's why I'm never going to need saplings in this type of Let's Play. But so let's see, we do have still quite a bit of inventory space left. Now let me just run and fill my canteen just because I want to have water with me when I leave. Now let's just try not to run off too far. Now of course I am going to be able to find more water on my way to the edge of the world, but to the edge of the map. But just to be sure, I'm just going to fill up water from these existing water bodies here because some... There we go, because actually some biomes in Rising World do not have access to water, and by that I mean some biomes like the ocean biome, even though it's comprised practically of water, you're not able to fill your canteen with it because obviously it's salty water which cannot be drank, so you cannot fill your canteen with it. It's not going to allow you to fill your canteen with it, like I showed in the previous episode, in the last episode, in episode 1. I've actually tried to fill up my water canteen from that water source over there, which looks like an ocean, and this is a beach biome, and I wasn't able to do that, so. Let's see, hopefully we're going to be able to sleep through the night. Actually, unlike in Minecraft, you are able to enter a tent at practically any time of the day. You are able to enter, a bed or a tent or a shelter like I'm sleeping in right now at any time of the day, and the difference is that if you enter a tent or basically any place that you can sleep in during the daytime, you're not going to be able to actually sleep through the night. And right here, as you can see, it basically the screen darkens, but we're not actually sleeping. It's not really actually skipping any time for us, so just go out and oh my god. This is amazing, guys. The time we've all been waiting for. Finally, I'm going on to my journey. I'm going to miss all of this, guys. I'm going to miss all of it. I'm just going to collect some of the torches right here. And yeah, let's head out into the journey. The never, never, ever ending journey. To get to the edge of the world in Rising World. It's really amazing stuff, guys. This is goodbye forever. Oh, actually, just so I'm able to know the coordinates of this area, I'm just going to go right here and then just save the position right here. Our position is 133, 60, and 114 west. There you go. So, yeah. Let's head out, guys. Let's head out. So let's see. So another thing why I really need the blocks for is just so I can know that I'm heading exactly into the same direction. Really, in Minecraft, you can really see where west is, where east is, where north, Well, right now we're, so let's see, that's north, east, south, west, north. In Minecraft, it's easier to see just because there are blocks, and you can see this is one direction, this is the second, third, and fourth. But in Rising World, it's a bit more difficult than that, just because you cannot really see what direction you're going to, so I'm most likely going to use this. So let's see, we're going to go eastward, hopefully, so there you go. We're going to go eastward practically forever and ever. Okay, now let's just collect these tomatoes right here. Let's collect some of these tomatoes right here. And there we go. Now let's see, there's a cow here. Now let me test out my sword on this. Okay. Now let me see. 4 beefsteak. I could use that. Oh, apples. A lot of wild fruits here. We're practically already filled up our inventory, so that's quite bad. So I'm not going to be able to collect much items. Now let's see, I'm going east. I have to go east. Right now we're going southeast, but I have to go east. Now one of the hardest parts of this let's play is actually going to be, oh, here we go, got this nice little boar here. So now let's see, what can we get from him? Some bacon, which I don't have inventory space for. Now let's see, maybe we're gonna be able to stack our existing, oh, there we go, just got 8 of that. Oh wow, we got some nice caves over here. Just collect some apples. There we go, 6 apples. Now, like I said, one of the hardest parts of this let's play is actually going to be staying basically entertained, and the reason for that is because I'm not going to be really doing anything too interesting for the course of this let's play. Okay, looks like we're not going to be able to stack any more of that. Now soon I'm actually going to stop collecting resources and just going to run. Now one thing, like I said, it was going to be difficult is actually going to be staying entertained, and the reason for that is because practically the only thing that I'm going to be doing in this whole let's play is just running in one direction. Although for me it is quite interesting, but it's not really fun to watch just because I'm just going to be running in one direction, and there's not really going to be too much danger facing me because, well, frankly, there's not really any mobs or any enemies in Rising World. They have been talking about adding some types of enemies or something. Wow. How'd they get in there? Just kind of jump down there. Okay, what is that? Oh, that's weird. I think those were cherries or something. Oh, wait, but cherries grow on a bush. Yeah, I actually don't know. Oh, there you go. I thought we just entered the snowy biome just because there was this kind of snow or something. Hey, I think this is a glitch. This shouldn't be snowy. This isn't a snowy biome. Why are these spawning like there's snow on them? And there are actually snowy biomes in here. You are able to collect snow in here. Oh. There's a nice, there's some kind of mud under here. And actually, one item that you can also collect in Rising World is mud and snow. You can create snow blocks from that, so that's also quite interesting. Now, another thing that I'd like to say is that running in Rising World does deplete quite a bit of hunger and thirst, so it's going to be quite beneficial to have lots of food supply in our inventory. Like I do right now, I have really a large amount of, okay, what are those? Looks like we're collecting them, but we're never actually, oh, were those apples? For some reason, it didn't say anything. It was supposed to say on the right-hand side, something times 1 or times 5 apple or something. I think those were cherries, but I just collected them, but weren't able to place them in my inventory just because my inventory is already all filled up. So I'm going to have to think about what I'm actually going to be able to, oh, wow. Now I'm actually going to have to start thinking about what I'm going to be able to throw out of my inventory just to conserve space. Okay, now we have a little water source here. Now this would be a great time to drink just because, so I'd be able to collect water from right here. So now let's see. I don't need to eat right now. I'm still going to wait on that a bit more. There we go. Yeah, the sword isn't really too efficient compared to the axe, because I usually use axes to fill, what's that? Oh, that's copper. You don't need that. Because I usually use axes to kill off, basically all animals or stuff like that. Oh, wow. This is just so beautiful. Oh my god. This is amazing, guys. This is just amazing. Or actually going eastward right here, so. Yep, there we go. So let's see, we're right now on negative 1,000 and, oh, there's just some gravel right here. So now let's see, can we just go right here? I really wish there were boats in Rising World. That would be very, very helpful, considering I won't have to swim as much. Because, you know, like there are boats in Minecraft, they're quite efficient, so maybe hopefully they're gonna add boats in the near future. Oh, let's see, do we have any space for... Oh, yeah. We do have some space for... We do have some space for coal, so we just filled up on that a bit here. Okay, let's see, that's iron ore right there. That's quite useful. No, so now let's think about what we can really throw out at this point. So let's see. I'm probably just going to throw out... Okay, as much as I like strawberries, I'm probably going to have to throw out the strawberries. And they disappeared down there, so... Let's just mine all that right there. And did we just collect all the stone? Oh, unfortunately, we collected the stone, so I'm just going to dump that all out right there. There we go. So now that got filled with iron ore, so right now I'm only going to collect iron ore. All of the other items that I'm going to drop, I'm not going to be able to collect just because there's no space in my inventory. Now, like I said, if I do have the opportunity to gather ores, I will stop by and gather ore, especially if it is iron ore, which is a very useful ore, like I said before. And when I do acquire enough iron ore, like 64 or so, I am going to stop eventually, and I am going to just simply build a furnace, just create a small base, and then from there, I'm going to... smelt all of that, so yeah. So now let's see. Is there any more? Oh, there's some coal there. So now let's see. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to basically alternate from I'm going to alternate from torch to my pickaxe, just because I don't have any torch mounts. I'm unable to mount any torches or any light sources such as those, so I'm just going to have to alternate between that. So let's see, are we just gathering, because that just kind of looks like, oh, that's still, I just thought that looked a bit like copper ore, but let's see. Oh, my inventory's full. Let's see, so does that mean that it's well, I'm still able to collect iron ore if there is any iron ore, so I'm just going to leave that as is. Oh, I think there's more iron ore. Yep, this is iron ore right here. So wait, how does it... Why did it say that my inventory is full if... Actually, I think that I'm going to throw out the dirt right here and see what it says then. Because how's my inventory full if I still have space to store iron ore? So let's see, we got some stone there. Stone there. Well, let's see, how's my inventory full? Well... I don't really need any more of that, so I'm probably just going to climb out of here. I'm just going to use my pickaxe to mine out, so there we go. We just collected some ore there, which is quite beneficial. So we're going eastward like we are usually right here. So let's see. Wow, some beautiful stuff here. I really love the new update with the water. It really enhances the environment. However, I do really wish that they add boats soon, just because I really need boats for this Let's Play. Because how am I going to get past really large bodies of water? Pretty much the only way is just going to be to swim through them by foot, basically. Well, not by foot, but I'm just going to have to swim through them... just not by foot, but like through just using my body, if you know what I mean. Oh, Now, accidentally, I just jumped a bit too high there, so unfortunately, I did get injured there a bit. So now, let's see if we're going eastward or we're going around that way. I mean, we could have ran past there, which I think would have been a bit more efficient, but I'm just going to go through here as well, so yeah. Now, thankfully, there hasn't been really two big water bodies that are in our way, just because there's really not... We don't really have to go that way. We can just go this way, so yeah. And I'm planning more Let's Plays to Rising World, because I'm also going to create... I'm going to make some Rising World Let's Plays in which I'm going to just survive or just create really large structures. One Rising World Let's Play that I wanted to do is just an architecture Let's Play where I'm going to just build a lot of things. And in that Let's Play, my goal is going to be to build as high structures as I can. I'm just going to build really, really modern and fancy... Okay, now let's eat just right now. I'm going to build really large and fancy structures, like apartment buildings, offices, just kind of like a city Let's Play build or something like that. Okay, now I'm not sure if I have gotten to... Is this a different beach or... Now, this is quite weird. I really hope that this is not the same place that I used to be in before, because that's going to kind of suck. But I don't really see my base anywhere here, so thankfully that doesn't look like it. But yeah. So now I'm just going to have to swim over this huge body of water. Hopefully there's going to be some land right there. We can see some land going off over there in the left-hand side. Now, to replenish health in Rising World is quite difficult, especially if you have little food. Especially if you have only, like... In Rising World, if you only have... In Rising World, meat products or something like that, that's the best way to replenish health in Rising World. However, if you have other food, like tomatoes, it's quite difficult to replenish food. You either have to have, like, a ridiculous amount of them, a ridiculously a lot of them. So, like I said... you do have to have a ridiculous large amount of tomatoes or basically any, like, farmed food to replenish health. If you do not have bacon or any such meat products or pork products, it's going to be difficult to replenish your health, just because tomatoes replenish and just farmed food replenishes very little amounts of health, or they replenish health very, very slowly. So the most efficient way to really replenish health is to go kill out some animals, gather their resources, gather their meat, cook their meat, and then that way is the most efficient way to replenish health. I have played in Let's Plays. Well, no, I mean, I have not made Let's Plays on these playthroughs, but I have played Rising World without actually filming it when I was playing a really hardcore map, which basically did not have any animals. It basically had very, very little amounts of green spots on it, and most of the other time, it was just, oh, that's weird. There's just little kind of... little weird spots of water here. And what's interesting is there's no waves here. Like, in real life, this would be much flatter, and there would be waves here. In most of the time. Most of the time. Oh, wow. Wow, what happened here? What is this? Wow. Wow, would you look at that? There's coral reefs here. Wow. And why is there stone here? That's quite weird. I have never saw such a geological formation in Rising World before. So actually, guys, I think that this Let's Play has been long enough. So thank you for watching. This was Minecralix. See you all in the next episode. We have gone quite far. As you can see, we are currently at negative 2,913.54. So yeah, we got about 2 or so kilometers away from the center of the map, so hopefully we will reach the edge of the world someday. I don't know if this is ever going to happen, but I do not have any intentions to stop filming these Let's Plays. So yeah, thank you for watching. This was Minecraftlix. See you all in the next video. I'll make a bunch more videos, including on Rising World, so stay tuned. Please like, subscribe, comment, and I'm out.